All right, this isn't easy. First and last?
First and last.
Paul Dontonville, Hamburg.
Georgia Rowland, Ipswich.
Emma Shaw, Chapel Hill.
Matt Powell, Norfolk.
Emily Reed, Georgia.
Nora Conway, Cambridge.
Isaac Amick, Bermuda.
George Turner, Aberdeen.
Chris Furby, Devon.
Charlie Fling, Santa Barbara.
Kubal Chinashik, Czech Republic.
Meredith Rowlands, Oxford.
Ed Woolgar, Kent.
Emerald Herrick Doyle, Birmingham.
Robert Billings, Eastern Maryland.
Thomas Thompson, London.
Sam O'Hare, Manchester.
Shelby Vaughan, Princeton.
Henry Chandler, Oundle.
We are the University of St. Andrews Boat Club.
We are all students at the best university in Scotland. But we are also rowers.
Deadlines come and go, so do papers and exams, but my rowing friends are always there for me.
Rowing and studying is very possible, you just need to manage your time properly and you should be fine.
I got more disciplined with my time and having to organize myself in order to organize the rest of the guys.
Rowing is something that I can always rely back on. And besides, there's no harder exam than a 2K test, really.
All of my homework, like now, and that's sort of the way my life always is. There's always some book club thing, some meeting I have to attend, or crisis to see to, which means I have to really be on top of my other real life responsibilities.
Most other people, I think, see when they hear that their friends are rowers, they only see what they give up. You're not out on the town every night, you don't wear non-spandex clothing, and you have all these blisters on your hands, and you're super dedicated, and they don't necessarily see what you give.
There's always someone training harder than you. You can't take an off day. You can't miss a stroke. You can't stop.
Rowing is not as easy as I thought initially.
We race in the Scottish Winter League against other universities and clubs. That's in Glasgow, Inverness and Aberdeen. In a way, the race has already begun.
Rowing in Scotland is cold and hard, but we get through it and we keep training.
Now I guess this is like my seventh consecutive year of being involved in rowing.
I've been rowing for 7 years.
11 years.
3 years.
4 years.
3 years.
3 years.
6 years.
When you do something you love, you just find time for it.
River Tay is a really lovely stretch of water. It's really long, relatively uninhabited, but we have Dundee just down the road.
I know that when I'm out on the water with the rest of the guys, working my heart out, rowing as hard as I can, then there's really no place I'd rather be.
Once you get the timing and the set and the rock over and the power and the right calls, there's no feeling like it.
What you get is being a part of your teammates in a way, because when you step in a boat together, you're no longer just an individual, but you're part of something much bigger, and everything that you do affects everyone else. So that's something that's really special. I sometimes feel like I am my best self when I'm rowing, and so I'm really grateful for my teammates that bring that to me.
This might be overused, but the boat club really is like a family. My actual family is about 6,000 miles away. But I know that when I need them the most, these people I can always rely on.
I feel proud to represent St. Andrews and that we can stand our ground against other universities who are perhaps better funded than us, perhaps have better resources than us, perhaps don't have to deal with the challenges that sometimes we have to deal with.
St. Andrews is just a beautiful place to live in, and the university is making a really big push to make its sports facilities and its sports clubs just better. And I think you can really tell the difference because everything's coming together now and we're really becoming much more serious in terms of how we compete and how we address our competition.
Henley is the goal.